Well, it looks like the last prehistoric planet video I made was about over a month ago. So I figured it was time I finally got back into doing my little review series. So let's jump right back in. Episode 3, Fresh Water. As soon as the episode starts, we are greeted to more flying reptiles. These pterosaurs are seen roosting on a cliff's edge, supposedly to keep them safe from predators. I'm really loving the sweet fawn pattern that they gave these baby pterosaurs. It definitely helps to give them a juvenile look. And happily, we are treated to getting to see more velociraptors appear. They are once again depicted as hunting as a pack. There is this really beautiful shot of all three velociraptors right next to the cliff, and their color scheme matches perfectly with the rocks behind them. Definitely dangerous to have a predator that is very good at camouflage. After some shenanigans by the velociraptors, there's this moment that I was very surprised to see that the female velociraptor wasn't injured after quite a fall. Seriously, if you haven't seen the episode, it almost looked a little ridiculous. I'm just impressed nothing was broken. Watching them hop around on the cliff's edge reminded me of my love for the Lost World PS1 game, and how I should do a video on that platformer. Eventually. The next scene takes us back to the T-Rex. I was so excited to see more of that big guy on the screen. He is said to be an older male, and we get to watch him eating a Triceratops. The narrator even takes a moment to show us some of his past battle scars. One of those scars is that his tail is missing the very tip to it. Makes you wonder who bit that off. But he unfortunately did sustain a new injury. Since not all hunts are successful, it's not surprising that serious, life-threatening injuries could occur. And then we get this cute little segment of him washing the wound off in a nearby river, only to meet another T-Rex. If you were expecting them to get into some kind of a territory fight, I've got news for you, buddy. They actually want to mate instead. We get this nice moment of getting to watch them try courtship out. The male lifts his head up high so that his throat is exposed. And then the female does the same, giving him the go-ahead symbol. And then we get to watch them nuzzle. How cute. The narrator actually makes a point at one moment referencing that T-Rex would have had very sensitive faces, so the nuzzling and touching would have hopefully felt pretty nice for them. In fact, the sensitivity of a T-Rex's face has come up in the news relatively recently. So yeah, I wouldn't have thought about how sensitive a Tyrannosaur's face was, but there you go. Up next, we get one of my favorite, very bizarre dinosaurs, Deinocheirus. These guys have had a bit of a transformation over the years in paleontology. In fact, for quite a while, the only bones we had from them was their arms. And gosh, these look absolutely menacing. The name, Deinocheirus, quite literally translates to horrible hand. So it's not hard to see why. In this depiction, we get to see it act more like a giant water buffalo, if anything. While they are shown with feathers, they're not quite the same as the velociraptor. Instead, the Deinocheirus is shown as having a very long, almost hair-like structure covering its body. I swear, when I was watching this episode, I just wanted to brush those poor feathers out on this guy. I'm also a big fan of the blue soft tissue that's shown on its neck. I always really enjoy seeing speculative art that includes extra soft tissue, since stuff like that obviously doesn't fossilize particularly well. If they did have colorful soft tissue on their body, that might have been used as sexual display for other members of its species. Oh, and I can't believe how beautifully shot the poop scene was. It's actually kind of ridiculous. The next bizarre animal we get to look at is my favorite pterosaur of them all, Quetzalcoatlus. With a wingspan of about 30 feet, this thing wasn't a joke. This segment is another example of showing us how pterosaurs might have cared for their young. After building a nest and laying her eggs, she's shown as basically not leaving the nest at all. She is consistently watching over them just to make sure that they don't get eaten. But unfortunately, the moment she does leave, that's exactly what happens. We see a rival female Quetzalcoatlus enter the forest as well. Upon discovering the nest, she then proceeds to destroy it.
Nom 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 babies!
So, another reminder on how unkind nature really can be. Aside from that though, I really love the model on this thing. Watching them make their way through the forest on the very long, extended fourth finger is incredible, actually. I'm just really happy with this depiction, and I don't have a whole lot of negatives to say about it. And then, the final section that I'd want to talk about today on this episode, we are then shown the superior creature, crab, the ultimate life form. Just kidding. The actual dinosaur in this part of the episode is Masiakasaurus. As you can see, the model has a variety of very small, tiny feathers right in between the scales on the body. Trust me, I'm always happy to see scales and feathers on the same dinosaur. And also, very sharp teeth on this one. If you've ever seen the skull of Masiakasaurus, it's quite an interesting one with the teeth jutting out of it. But of course, the most current theory is that most land-dwelling dinosaurs would have had some kind of a lip structure hiding their teeth. So, not a bad design choice here. And unfortunately, we're gonna get a little bit more baby death with this one. Only this time, the killer is Beelzebufu, devil toad. In fact, one of the largest toads that we've ever found. As you can imagine, a lot of memes popped up in the paleo community around this guy, so...
Masiakasaurus had never seen such bullfrog before.
And that's the end of the episode. My final thoughts on this one is, I really enjoyed it a lot. There wasn't too many dull moments in this episode, so I never found myself getting bored. In fact, I just kept getting more excited to see what creature would pop up next. This episode had quite a few interesting giants to go over, from the Deinocheirus, Quetzalcoatlus, and of course T-Rex. I genuinely feel like all these interesting designs of these dinosaurs is really going to help with finding new fans when it comes to paleontology. I'm really hoping that's the case. Thank you guys for watching this week's video. I'd love to know what your favorite segment might have been from this episode, or maybe you had a least favorite part. Feel free to comment down below, and maybe even consider giving this video a like if you learned anything new. Thanks so much again for watching this, and I'll see you all next time.